The end is near, my friends. We have found Vorthra's hiding place.
Unrepentant villains, will you not be satisfied until you have brought disaster down upon your own heads? By your wickedness, you stand to gain this conflict. Had you only trusted fate to me, there would have been peace for all. You could have lived this in my eternal paradise, free from the burdens of conscience and purpose.
Peace assumes many forms. And I do not doubt that you considered yours well worth the cost. I was even prepared to believe that the end might justify the means. Ignorant as I was, I had hoped that you might mend your ways and join hands with us, that we might strive together for the happiness of all. But no more. Your actions cannot be reconciled with your words. Peace for all, you say? Yet when you were threatened, your first act was to sacrifice your own people in order to save yourself. If your paradise can be rebuilt so long as you alone survive, it exists not for the people. It exists solely for your twisted pleasure.
Hear me, Vorthri. The people won't submit to your will, for we each have our own. I made a promise to a noble soul, a woman who saw fit to entrust me with her legacy, and I mean to keep it. Everyone who stands with us has something precious, something that they cherish and would die to protect. They know their own hearts. They know what they want for this world. And by lending their strength to our cause, they have spoken. No matter how hard you may try to bend the world to your will never yield!
Silence! Not another word! You presume to lecture me. Insolent worms, you will learn your place. With my true powers awakened, I will expunge you like the filth you are. Your demise will serve as a reminder to all that I am the Zenith of mankind and Sin-Eater both, chosen to rule over creation by right of transcendence. My very existence is virtuous. I am perfect, immaculate.
He seems disinclined to grant us an audience.
Find Vorthri. We will hold the Eaters here. Come, let's finish this.